City, who were charged with the responsibility of registering vulnerable people during the COVID-19-induced lockdown, who have been ordered to refund the 100,000 Uganda shillings they each received after they registered themselves irregularly. The Local Government Accounts Committee of Parliament has also handed them over to police to record statements as more investigations are undertaken.
The 8 data entrants today appeared before the Local Government Public Accounts Committee of Parliament, which is probing the fraudulent process of registering beneficiaries meant to receive the COVID-19 relief of 100,000 shillings. The committee, however, established that the same people who were charged with registering names had to register their names first as beneficiaries, taking advantage of the system.
Mr. Town Clerk, how did this data entry officials, the officers you assign with the responsibility of entering names of vulnerable people registered from wherever they are, how did they turn around to register themselves?
Data entrants pleaded guilty but told the committee that they are all volunteers in Arua City and needed the money. Of the 14 data entrants from Arua City, 8 said they were willing to return the money and regretted what they did.
I registered myself as a waitress.
As a waitress?
Yes.
Have you ever been a waitress?
No.
Use the microphone.
No.
Have you ever been a waitress?
No.
No. So why did you do that?
I don't have anywhere I get money, so I thought I could benefit.
You thought that was an opportunity of getting money?
Yes.
And how do you feel about it?
I'm sorry. I registered as a food vendor.
You registered as a food vendor? Have you ever been a food vendor?
Yes.
Where was that?
That was after graduation.
After graduation?
Yes.
So you thought now that you are the data entry officer, you thought you can manipulate and put that memory on the system?
I'm very sorry, sir. I apologize. I did so, but I wasn't supposed to do that.
The committee chairperson, Martin Ujara Mapenduzi, questioned why the whole process was left to the volunteers who are not paid. However, the city officials said the process was left to the statisticians.
Arua City has recruited volunteers, people who do not have, if I may ask, do you have any formal document to show that these are volunteers working with your entity?
During that time, the deputy handled that, and they had some documents.
Can you let your deputy talk, because looks like these are things that happen when you were not around.
The committee was shocked to establish that hundreds of female boda-boda riders were registered to receive the 100,000 shillings, and yet there are only 2 female boda-boda riders in Arua City.
According to Mr. Salim, he says there are only 2 female boda-boda riders. 2 female boda-boda riders that everyone know. But in this document, you have registered so many female boda-boda riders. Can you tell us where you got them from?
The 8 data entrants, together with 3 Arua officials, were handed over to the police to record statements. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.